One of the key features with DM7 series version 1.6 is the object-based immersive mix control included in the theater package. Let's see what it does and learn how to get that set up. Remember, the theater package is included with the DM7 control panel, or you can purchase it separately with either size of DM7 console. To use the immersive control functions, start in the setup menu and choose network. Touch immersive, and if you see a blank screen, touch to select AFC image. In case you're wondering what AFC image is, well, Yamaha has been using AFC or active field control technology to enhance the acoustic environment of performance venues for a couple of decades now, using a range of microphones, signal processing, and carefully positioned loudspeakers. More recently, AFC Image was introduced as a creative and immersive mixing tool for positioning and providing motion to multiple sound objects around a space with multiple loudspeakers in front of, to the side, above, and behind the audience. Unusual sizes, layouts, and shapes of venue can be compensated and catered for, providing the audiences with the best possible live sound experiences. AFC Image relies upon a dedicated external processor, which should be connected within the same network as the DM7 mixer control port, with a compatible IP address. DM7 is going to be used to remotely control the position of each audio object. There'll probably be a Dante connection between the DM7 and the AFC image processor to transfer audio signals via direct outs and mix buses, but the mixer control is vital for data communication. For example, if the mixer control IP address is set to 192.168.0.2, with a subnet of 255.255.255.0, then the AFC image device must also have an IP address starting with 192.168.0, but with a unique last number. The 3D sound positioning of AFC image is object-based, where an object can be a single channel, a pair of channels, or a large group of channels. So the first job is to determine the relationship between console channels and the AFC objects. Open the object assign screen to do exactly that. Up to 128 objects are supported, and the sequential patch can be used for a fast setup of multiple channels. When input channels are assigned, their input patch is shown and their direct out settings, which will be used to transfer the audio from the DM7 to the AFC image processor. For now, if there are stereo channels, assign the left side to an object and the right side to the next object. The objects will be paired within the AFC image editor. If a mix bus is assigned to an object, such as for a complete drum kit or horn section, then its output patch will be visible and editable in the object assign grid. Don't miss the handy shortcut on the right side of the screen, Generate Custom Fader. This will populate a range of fader layers with all the channels assigned to objects for fast and easy access. Note you can manually assign the immersive main and reverb faders to a custom layer or to one of the main faders on the right. Now you can return to the immersive setup screen. Channel pair or stereo object settings can be copied between console and AFC image, copying from the source that was set up first. Channel or object names can also be copied, saving a lot of time retyping. Use the scene recall sync if you want AFC image scenes to recall with console scenes. They don't have to exactly match the same scene number. The linking is done individually in the scene menu. When you open the scene menu and view the scene list, you'll now find a tab for AFC image. Open this and assign an AFC image scene number to each console scene you wish to use as a trigger. Now let's see how to control the positioning of each object. Press Home to see the selected channel screen and select a channel which is assigned to an object. Remember, you could use the custom fader layers to find the assigned channels quickly. You can see the object positioning grid above the EQ curve next to the inserts. Don't confuse this with the 5.1 surround panning, which is part of the DM7 series broadcast package, because that would be seen in the mix send area. Touch the grid to see the immersive object control screen. On the console, the object positioning always occurs within this square, though a performance area is rarely this shape. So adjust the rendering area for each loudspeaker zone in AFC Image Editor software to provide a realistic conversion between the console's panning grid and the target space for the loudspeakers. Make sure this control button is highlighted, and XY panning can be changed by dragging the red dot or by tapping at a new location in the grid. The Z axis positioning or elevation can be adjusted with the third encoder below the screen. Width and height related to the object's size are adjusted from encoders 5 and 6, while 8 and 9 are used for reverb and aux sends. The AFC image processor includes a special 3D reverb with various highly realistic hall patterns. Enable Ascend by touching on. The aux send could be used as a low frequency effect channel if you wish. A solo button is included for use while setting up and sound checking, though it gets disabled when AFC image is in show mode. Now, if you have the DM7 control panel, it's worth setting its panner target to AFC image. Do that in the DM7 control setup screen. The encoder can be assigned to the Z parameter, or to width, height, or reverb send. Then use either auto grab or the manual grab switch to suit your preferred method. And then set relative or absolute panning as you wish. Use the assign key as a shortcut to show the immersive panner on the screen. Then object 1 to 36 can be touched, or an adjacent button to get a multi-channel overview. Quick copy and paste are available here. Tap once to select an object. Tap again to see the object's details. Bear in mind that you won't see any of this without having an AFC image processor connected. If you do have one, you're going to really appreciate the easy controls, making complex motions and positioning tasks quick and simple. To find out more about AFC Image, look on our website, yamaha.com, and search AFC. From there, you can download the AFC Image editor so you can run the software offline and get to know it better. With up to 128 objects as inputs and 64 loudspeakers as outputs arranged in up to 32 zones, there's huge potential to create immersive experiences in any performance area and in multiple audience areas. In the meantime, don't miss the other videos about new features in DM7 series version 1.6, including the new optional Dante PY64D card and 5.1 surround monitoring for broadcast applications. I'll be seeing you again soon.